I would say that after Andhra Pradesh has been formed, we have come out with a mission document. And in the mission, we have given a clear target for ourselves. In terms of tourist arrivals, we want to increase from 93 million to 178 million. We want to increase investments in the tourism sector to 10,000 crores. We want to increase the international arrivals to about 5 lakhs, about 500,000. So that's the way we have set up. We have also set up a target of how much it should contribute to the GDP in terms of money. So that's one part of it. The second is the strategy, what you asked for. There are two major changes that we have brought about. We have identified 9 themes and 42 sub-themes within these themes, which we are targeting around 5 tourist hubs. So we have identified 5 focused tourist hubs, divided it into 9 themes and into 42 sub-themes, and targeting those areas for tourist development. I'll talk about 2 of them a little later with you. But the second major change which we are bringing about, now that's a very, very major change in the way we do business. We have now mobilized our local entrepreneurs, the Indian entrepreneurs, and even I would say international investors. And we are mobilizing private investments in a very, very big way. We want to make it clear that government is not going to run the tourism business. Government is going to facilitate the tourism business. It's the private enterprise which will run the business. And we are very successful till now. Just to share with you, we have till now targeted and got 12,000 crores of investments lined up for the state of Andhra Pradesh purely in the tourism sector. Now that's a very good beginning, I would say. The moment all these things come to ground, we will be able to do this. Government is very focused not only on tourism but on the whole economy. We have set a target that the state of Andhra Pradesh will go for a double-digit growth. That means we will grow at more than 10%. When the world over, you know the situation, India is already an island of economic, I would say, growth, and Andhra Pradesh is going to be island within that island, growing at double-digit growth. For tourism, we have targeted that we will contribute 7% of that state GDP from the tourism sector. In terms of concrete numbers, in real terms, we are targeting an increase from 30,000 crores of what we have right now to about 40 to 45,000 crores of rupees. Now that's something very big. So you know, that's something very big. So that's what we are talking about in terms of GDP. Now for example, for Spain, I give the focus area of Visakhapatnam. This is a beautiful city. It's a city which was set up somewhere with the colonial rulers at that time. It was initially with the Netherlands, Bhimunipatnam. We have a lot of Dutch heritage here. We have a lot of English heritage here. The most important, it is a city of beaches and hills. It's beautiful. You can see the whole sea from a cliff top. And you know, the scene can be mesmerizing. It is a place where you have the valleys, you have the hills, you have the tribals, you have a full-fledged gamut of things to see. It's a perfect destination for any person who wants to come and spend some leisure time. We are also targeting it as a business MICE destination. So that's something which is also going side by side. But for a family, for an individual traveler, this would be one very good thing. The other destination which I wanted to talk to, this is, people may confuse, which is this area. This is the Kona Sima backwaters. This is the new backwaters of incredible India. And this is as beautiful, if not more, than the existing backwaters. And this is the new destination we are developing. It is serviced by a Rajahmundry airport. We have big hotels in Rajahmundry, Kakinada. It has mangroves. It has bird sanctuary. It has a lot of fish cultivation. It has rural life. It has artisans. It has handlooms. It has handicrafts. It has the beautiful River Godavari. It has the River Godavari coming down from the Eastern Ghats. It's an experience which I'm sure any person would not like to miss. And I think this is a new destination. We have a French heritage in this place. which is very close to this. We have a place, we have an enclave, which is called Yanam. So this place we want to target also for the French market, because Yanam is a place still preserving a lot of French. In fact, for your information, they have constructed a duplicate Eiffel Tower here in Yanam. And Yanam is right within this area, in right in the middle of this area. So this is French, that's Dutch, a lot of European were taking there. The figures, of course, you know, are very simple to project, because you can always project the figures that we will reach here. But what 20 years hence or 10 years hence, what we are very clear on. Number one, we are here for responsible tourism. We are here for tourism with local participation. I talked about local entrepreneurs, but everywhere we are making sure that there is a local participation in the activities. We are here for middle-end and high-end tourism. We are not for local, I would say cheap tourism. We are very clear on that. All our products are at the, I would say, middle-end and the higher end of the market. And that's one thing we want to preserve. We want to be the destination where you want to be, not where you go by default.